Hello children, hope you're all doing fine in this pandemic situation. Yes, I know you're missing the real classes, real benches, and we are all missing you people. But still, something is better than nothing. Learning is the best part of a student, and it is the responsibility as well as the duty of our teacher to make their students learn. I welcome you all to my English class. Today, we'll be dealing about articles. You all have studied about articles in your previous classes, like it's been started in the 7th, 8th, 9th. But today, we'll sum up all those things and we'll begin our class. As you know, articles. How many articles are there? Yes, there are three articles classified into two groups. Correct? One is definite article, the other is indefinite article. Definite article, the name itself suggests here we are talking about a specific thing which we know as well as the listener or the reader knows about it. It's hence the name specific or a definite article. So there is one definite article, that is the. And the other group is indefinite article. Indefinite article, there are two articles, that is a or an. As you know, a is used before a consonant sound. It's most important to have a sound whenever I pronounce a word. For example, I can tell you R. What is it? It's okay. Let me write it at the above. For example, this is hover. You can call it hover because it's beginning with H. But let I tell you, in R, H is silent. We are not supposed to pronounce the word H. Hence I told consonant sounds matters a lot, not only a consonant word. Like bag. It's a consonant sound. So it is ye bag. But this and ah. Is this correct? I hope you are getting. And is used for vowel sounds. Okay? And this is indefinite article, this is definite article. I hope indefinite articles are ye or an, and definite article is the. I hope this is clear. Now, let me deal about indefinite article. As you all know, there are two articles, indefinite article, ye or an. Firstly, ye or an is used before a singular countable noun. What is a singular countable noun? For example, I can say this is a chalk, right? You can say this is a green chalk. I'm using a chalk. I can count this one. This is one. In quantity it is one. This is only a chalk, so it is a chalk. What if I take two chalks? If I take two chalks, it is like, I can't say it is these two chalk, a two chalks. Is this correct? This is a wrong usage. You can't say this is ye chalks. Ye is used only for a singular countable noun, or an is also used for a singular countable noun. This indefinite article is basically used for singular countable noun. For example, I can say this is a box because this is in quantity, it is a singular noun. Or I can say this is a mask. I can't say these are two masks, but I can count it. This is only one in quantity, hence it is a mask. Or I can say an apple. A singular apple. This is an apple. Because it is one in quantity. Hence it is an apple, a chalk, a mask, a bottle, a chair, a towel.